Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'll show you how to do a animation like this. All I am using for this is actually a lot of PNG files, which are a lot of individual parts, so you can move the parts individual, right? Okay, let's go into Fusion and figure out how we can do that. Oh, and by the way, you can do this without Fusion. You can just do it in the editor using a lot of layers, but it is kind of easier to do this in Fusion. So let's go to Fusion and do that in Fusion. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve. And first off, we'll go to the effect library and go into the effects and then take a Fusion composition and drag that down so we have something to work with in Fusion. So let's go to Fusion. So in Fusion, we have now our media out node, which we are going to drag at the end here. And then I'm going to put in a background because we need to have some size. I'll just give it a random color, something bluish. And then I'll just connect the background to the media out here. And I have a lot of PNG layers. In fact, I have 16 layers, so I'm just going to put in 16 merge nodes. So I'll just click here 16 times, which is a lot, actually. It's a lot of layers and a lot of individual things we can move around. So here we have it. It's a bit hard on one screen actually to have a good view, but we'll do our best. Okay, so here we have a bunch of merged nodes. And now I'll just start by taking all the individual parts down to the composition here. Okay, so we'll drag down our first layer and I'll then right click on the layer and I'll drag that in. I'll make sure that this is going to be our foreground. And then I'll go to our media out. And then I can control which of the two screens I want to see my media out in. So just have a look here. Okay, I'll just disconnect this from here and then just make a little bit of space. And then I'll just reconnect, make it to the foreground. And then I'll go to my out point and I'll push 2 on the keyboard. So this is what we have here. So this is our first layer. And then I'll just do the exact same thing again. I'll just make a bit of room because I need to have some nodes in between some of the layers here later. So let's go to our second layer and I'll connect that and make sure that this is the foreground. Like that. So here we have the first. And I think you get the basic idea of this. So let's just speed this up in post with some 80s music underneath. Okay, so with everything connected here, I am going to change the background color to something else than the blue, because I think I would prefer another color. Maybe we'll just do some kind of yellow, I think. Yeah, yellowish. Well, that is absolutely too yellow, so we'll just change that and we'll do something more a bit vintage, I believe. Okay, so this is the basic of our composition. So now we need to a fast way of renaming everything is, of course, highlighting everything and pushing F2 on your keyboard and then just rename. And let's just speed this up in post as well. So with all our medias now being named and everything ready to be animated. So let's go in and then we'll just go in and add a grid warp. And I'll add that in between this one here. So in the inspector, of course, we can change the how much we can move around. And it is just this layer is just her hand actually on his shoulder. So we can just make the grid size way smaller, and also the strength a bit smaller. Okay. So that's fine. Something like that. Okay, so now we can start to do our animation. I'll just zoom in here. So first off, let's go down here and right click and then just start to do our animation. So I'll do that at the first frame. I'll go to the last frame in our animation here, and then I'll just manipulate her hand so it will move at a certain point over time. There we go. And we'll just go through it pretty fast. This is going to be super small movement, but I think it'll be just fine for this example at least. So we are just going to continue in that route, and then again I will speed this up. I will do all of these with the grid warp or with super simple transform nodes. Okay, there we have it. So with everything now being animated. So one thing we could do with this animation is we could add, or I think we should add, all the places where we do have movements, I think we should add some motion blur. And we can do that by going down to the merge, clicking here, and then just going down to the motion blur and check the box. And I will just do that for all of them. And as you can see on my motion blur, the shutter angle is 180 degrees, which is pretty standard. And I'll just continue to do this with all the notes which are moving. Okay, and let's do another one. And again, add some motion blur. Let's move the composition a bit. Again, add motion blur. So I'm doing all the motion blurs in the merge node. You can also do it in the transform. Just keep that in mind. So one little last thing I think we need to do. We need to do some kind of a zoom or something would be nice. So to move everything in the composition, of course, we would just add in a transform node. And okay, I added that there. I don't want to have that there, so I'll just delete that one and delete this. And I'll do it one more time. Okay, I have a transform node. I'll just delete this one. And then I will hold down shift and I'll drag that transform node down until the line is blue. And then I'll just go in the transform node and I'll just go to the beginning of the composition, add a keyframe, and then I'll go to the end of the composition like so, and then I'll just zoom in a bit, something like that. Okay, so let's have a look. There you have it. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.